How do you check the purity of honey? This is the most frequently asked question whenever natural honey is discussed. This video has everything you need to know about checking the purity of honey. This video focuses on 5 topics. Number 1. Different types of fake honey or adulterants. Number 2. The wrong, misleading, and outdated methods of testing honey. Number 3. Present-day laboratory parameters set by regulatory authorities. Number 4. Advanced laboratory tests which can identify the adulterations. Number 5. Things to remember when buying honey. Let's first start with the most commonly used adulterants. In early days, molasses was the common adulterant, but it is no longer in use because it readily dissolves in water and smells like jaggery. Another adulterant is liquid glucose, which is a thick and shiny solution made in factories and frequently used in baking and confectionery industries. The next in line is invert sugar, which is manufactured by processing refined sugars. This thick, shiny liquid is usually sold as honey-grade invert sugar. Next up is high fructose corn syrup. As the name suggests, it is made from sweet corn. Last and most common of them all is rice syrup. This sophisticated adulterant is used worldwide nowadays. It is getting manufactured through the unique processing of rice. It is also imported in India on a large scale. Most of these adulterants are harmful to our health and have been linked with diabetes and cardiac problems, which is why we should always choose natural honey. Now, let's discuss a few conventional tests which people have been using for ages to identify the purity of honey. The most popular among them is the solubility test, in which honey is made to fall slowly in a glass of water. If honey reaches the bottom of the glass and dissolves lately, then that honey is considered pure. However, not many know that except molasses, all other adulterants behave in the same manner as pure honey, as the solubility depends on the thickness of the given product. The adulterants are made deliberately thicker to appear like pure honey. Hence, this test is misleading. The other frequently used test is burning a cotton, paper, or sometimes currency note wetted with honey. Some people believe that if honey is pure, it will not catch fire, while some other believe the exact opposite. This is again a baseless and misleading test, as the burning tendency depends on the moisture level or thickness of the given product. Another test says that you have to allow honey to fall on a cloth. If it flows without wetting the cloth, it is considered pure. This is also a misleading test, as any thick solution behaves in the same manner as pure honey. Another test that is popular on the internet includes taking a little honey in an open mouth container, adding water to it and shaking it clockwise. The general belief is that pure honey forms a hexagonal shape or honeycomb-like pattern on the bottom of the container. This is a baseless and unscientific test because all thick adulterants behave in the same manner. There is also a myth that ants do not get attracted to pure honey. Again, this is a baseless myth, and there is no reason why ants will not get attracted towards such a sweet substance. In fact, honeybees form a sticky lining of propolis to protect its hive from the attack of ants and insects because they are attracted to the honey. Another popular myth that people believe is that dogs will not eat pure honey. It is again a baseless myth, as there is no reason why a hungry dog will not eat pure honey. Of course, if the dog isn't hungry, it's not going to eat anything, whether it's honey or not. Many more tests like these exist in different cultures, but the truth is that no conventional test can identify the purity of honey. Because all these tests judge only the physical nature of honey, and all new age adulterants are manufactured to mimic the physical nature of honey. If testing the purity of honey would have been that easy, then the market would not have been flooded with this amount of adulterated honey. Just consider this. According to a recent report, 70% of the honey sold in the market is adulterated. That's 7 out of 10 jars of honey is adulterated. To really check the purity of honey, you need to go to the laboratory and get the advanced test done. Yes, only laboratory tests can tell you which honey is pure. But the irony is that our laboratory parameters are still outdated, and advanced testing parameters are not yet implemented. Here we will discuss both the present-day parameters and also the advanced tests which are not yet implemented. Please note that the procedure of each test is not in the scope of this video, as it may be very long and irrelevant to the non-technical persons. There will be a separate video on this topic in the future. Here is the list of present-day parameters. Fees test. Aniline chloride tests. Specific gravity. Moisture content. Total reducing sugar. Presence of sucrose. Fructose-glucose ratio. total ash, hydroxymethyl furfural content, water insoluble matters, bee pollen count, acidity as formic acid. All these tests were designed decades back to check the purity and quality of honey. These testing parameters were sufficient to counter adulterants like molasses, liquid glucose, and invert sugar. But these tests were not designed to identify the high fructose corn syrup and rice syrup. This significant flaw has encouraged many brands to sell these adulterants as pure honey. Here is the list of advanced tests which can identify corn syrup and rice syrup. Carbon isotope test for C4 sugars. Proline quantity. Electrical conductivity. Diastase activity. Foreign oligosaccharides. Special marker for rice syrup, SMR. Trace marker for rice syrup, TMR. Nuclear magnetic resonance test, NMR. By using these sophisticated laboratory testings, we can identify all types of adulterants. Proper implementation of these testing parameters is expected to decrease the adulteration practice, at least in the organized sector or in big brands. Once implemented, we may find a marked decrease in the quantity of honey sold on the shelves of supermarket. Meanwhile, we have a few suggestions for you to choose real honey. Look for the local source of honey, be it a wild bee's honey or beekeepers or apiary honey. When buying wild bee honey, keep in mind that wild bee honey will always be cloudy as it is extracted by squeezing honeycombs. It will not be shiny or transparent. When choosing beekeepers or apiary honey, you should make sure that the honey has a taste and aroma specific to that area. If it is difficult to find local honey, then do the following. Search for a brand which has direct access to the source of honey and can provide you varieties of honey. It is always wise to demand varieties because synthetic or adulterated brands cannot offer you varieties of honey. Another instruction to keep in mind is don't fall prey to ultra clear shiny honey. Always remember, natural honey has bee pollen content. Another small technique which I use personally is to smell the honey immediately after opening the lid. Natural honey has a smell which gives a hint of source of flowers, whereas the fake honey usually has a plain sugary smell unless some honey flavor is added. Of course, a little experience may help, but as the different area honey has a distinct aroma, you need to be familiar with each area's honey. One more thing to keep in mind that sometimes you may procure the real natural honey, but when it crystallizes, you may reject it, considering to be fake or adulterated. The fact is that natural honey, especially in raw form, crystallizes sooner or later. Armed with this knowledge, when you go out to buy honey, you are now more likely to select pure honey. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask us your questions in the comments. Also, for more videos on natural honey, please subscribe to my YouTube channel.